A technician does not get fired because he does not know his refrigeration cycle. A technician gets fired because he misdiagnoses an air conditioning system. Now, in this video, I'm going to go ahead and share with you all one of the biggest reasons why a new technician gets fired and misdiagnoses an air conditioning system. So go ahead and stick around, and I'll share that with you right now. All right, so let's go ahead and get started. Let me go ahead and share with you all the biggest reason, or if you're a new technician out there in the field, one of the biggest reasons why a new technician misdiagnoses an air conditioning system, well, it has to do with what I have here on this whiteboard. It has to do with airflow, all right? I've seen where a lot of new technicians, and if you're a new technician out there in the field, I've seen where a lot of companies, they kind of don't give the technician the training that they need to go ahead and succeed out there in the field, all right? Now, some companies do provide this. I've seen some companies where they just don't go ahead and give that proper training, but that's okay. That's what we're here for. That's why I'm gonna go ahead and share with you all what you all need to go ahead and do in order for you all to diagnose an air conditioning system as best as you can, all right? So, when it comes to airflow, all right, remember, I'm gonna go ahead and put a scenario. Whenever you go and get sent out to a service call, there's a lot of things that go through your mind. A lot of things that what may go wrong, or what could go wrong, or what if I don't diagnose the system correctly? And that's totally fine. As a new technician, you get nervous, you get a little bit scared, but that's okay. That's part of the growing process, all right? And I'm going to go ahead and share with you all these tips on what to do to kind of calm your mind and have a better understanding and get better as you progress out there in the field, all right? So you go out there to the field, you get a service call, and what is it that happens? Okay, so let's say your boss says, look, I need you to go out there in the field and I need you to go ahead and check this air conditioning system. This customer stated that there's only hot air that's coming out from the vents. Okay, so what is it that you think that it could be? So it could be that, well, there's hot air coming out from the vent. More likely, my indoor system is running. Okay. So then that probably means that my outdoor system is not working the way it should. So then what I have to do is, instead of me going and attacking the whole system, I need to just go ahead and go over there and attack the outdoor system. But before you go ahead and do that, because it could be many problems, it could be that your thermostat is not sending a signal outdoors. It could be that your capacitor went out. It could be that your contactor went out. Or it could be the compressor itself. It could be the refrigerant. It could also be the fan motor that went out. There's many possibilities, all right? And that's why we're being sent out there, to go ahead and diagnose the system correctly. But before we do that, a lot of technicians, like I'm mentioning to you, or I mentioned to you in the beginning, a lot of technicians misdiagnose an air conditioning system because they do not check for airflow. And that's what I want you to go ahead and do. Every time that you go out there and check an air conditioning system, I want you to remember this. If an HVAC system does not breathe properly, it does not perform properly. Now, I'm going to go ahead and repeat that. If an air conditioning system does not breathe properly, it does not perform properly. So I don't care if you have gone and checked the air conditioning system for the first time, or you've checked it for the millionth time, you always want to go ahead and check airflow before you do anything else. So what does that mean? Okay, so what that means is, I broke it down for you all here on the whiteboard. What that means is that whenever you go and you approach the air conditioning system, these are the things on basic form, these are the things that you want to check for whenever it comes to airflow, all right? So you go into a customer's house. They stated that the system is only blowing hot air through your indoor system. All right, before you go ahead and move any further, what you want to go ahead and do is, you want to go ahead and check this one right here. I know it's the third one that I've written down right here, but that's the one you want to go ahead and check for first. You want to go ahead and check the air filter. Now, there's been many times, myself included, And you could be guilty of this as well, where we forget to change our air filter for our air conditioning system. I've seen it many times as my experience as part of the trade, where a lot of customers, they just forget to change the air filter. So then go ahead and check the air filter. If the air filter is restricted, if it's clogged, if it's dirty, then there's not going to be adequate airflow going in through your air conditioning system. So if you need to replace it, replace it. Tell the customer, explain to them why they need to go ahead and maintain a schedule to go ahead and replace that filter. Or you could go ahead and throw a maintenance schedule for them and tell them, okay, look, this is included with an air filter change as well. So you're going to go ahead and check your air filter first. The next thing that I want you to check is this right here, your evaporator coil. Now your evaporator coil, what you want to go ahead and do is you want to check if there's nothing obstructing that coil, if it's not dirty, if there's no pet hair, dirt, debris, any type of gunk, mess, whatever you want to call it, if there's nothing obstructing or nothing on that coil. Another thing is you want to check that there is no damage to the coil as well. If there's any damage to the coil, then you got to go ahead and replace it. Why? Because no adequate airflow is able to pass through that coil, and so the coil or the system is going to go ahead and suffer. So you have to go ahead and replace it. All right, so after we check, or in this case, after you check the evaporator coil, the next thing you want to go ahead and check is this one right here, the second one, which is your blower wheel. The blower wheel is the one that actually helps push the air. In this case, it forces the air through your coil. Why? Because it pushes the air through the bottom of your air conditioning system and then out through the top. It goes through your ducting system and then it comes out of your vents. All right, so let me go ahead and tell you a quick story. There was this one time where I went to go service an air conditioning system. So what was happening is the evaporator coil was freezing up on me. I automatically thought, well, the evaporator coil is probably dirty. So what I did is what any other technician does. They're going to go ahead and wash and clean that coil. So I got my tools, I pulled out the coil, and I started washing it, cleaning it. I did everything what I was supposed to do, and I put the coil back in. All right, so after I did that, I turned the system back on, and the coil started to do the same thing. It started to freeze on me. And I was like, well, it must be the coil. It's probably damaged on the inside. Something is going on. Now, I was relatively new out there in the field myself at that time, and I said, okay, so it's the coil. It's got to be the coil. What else can it be? So I gave a quote to the customer. In this case, well, the company gave a quote to the customer, and they decided to get a second opinion. They brought another technician to service their air conditioning system, and it turns out that the problem was not the coil. The problem was actually that the blower wheel was dirty. The blower wheel was not allowing the air, in this case, because fins were dirty and they were full of dirt and debris, they weren't grabbing enough air and forcing it through the coil, which that means that my coil's temperature and pressure was just dropping. Why? Because there's no heat load that's going through the coil, which was causing my coil to freeze. In this case, the customer's coil to freeze. And so I misdiagnosed that air conditioning system. Did I feel bad? Yes. But did I learn from that experience? Of course I did. Now I remember to check. Always check airflow. So after you go ahead and check your blower wheel, the next thing you want to go ahead and check is your return. Where your filter goes, the one that connects your air filter and the filter base to the actual system, that duct, is it broken? Is it ripped? Is there hot air from the attic going through it? Is it obstructed? Is it crushed? What's going on with it? Check it. Make sure you go ahead and you find out that there's nothing wrong with that airflow, or there's no hot air coming from the attic and through that return into your system, because that may cause a problem and that may cause you to misdiagnose an air conditioning system as well. So now, after we're satisfied and we check everything that is going on inside of my air handler system based on airflow, and I'm happy, and once again, I'm satisfied with that, the next thing that I'm going to go ahead and do is I'm going to go outside and I'm going to go ahead and check now, which is my condenser system. So what you're going to go ahead and check, if there's nothing causing any obstruction of airflow going into your condenser system. So after we're satisfied and we understand that, you know, there's nothing going on with the condenser system, there's no airflow restriction. What do I mean by this? Well, my condenser system is outside. It battles a lot of the elements. You have to understand that a lot of individuals, what they end up doing is, especially if it's in a customer's home, they cut the grass, right? So if they cut the grass, a lot of loose grass, a lot of dirt, debris. Now, a lot of these air conditioning systems, these condenser systems, they have some protective coverings. These coverings, they're good. What I mean by that is that they'll go ahead and protect the coil as best as they can. But what's actually going to happen is, because these coverings are very compact and very close together, they tend to gather a lot of dirt, a lot of debris, a lot of dust, pet hair. If the customer has pets outside, a lot of grass, shavings, all this stuff tends to gather inside of those, inside of that housing, and it creates kind of like a layer. So what you have to go ahead and do is you have to remove those coverings, and then you have to go ahead and clean the condenser coil. Go ahead and wash it, clean it, and then restore the adequate airflow, or the correct airflow going through your condenser coil. Now, let me share with you another story that may happen that I want you as a new technician or maybe an experienced technician to avoid. So let's say, for example, you go out there in the field and you find out that the customer states, okay, so an example, just like the example we gave earlier in the video, let's go ahead and state that the customer mentions that there is only hot air coming out through the vents. Okay, fine. What that means is probably your outdoor system that's not working. So you go out there and you check that your outdoor system, of course, is certainly not working. So you take out your tools and you find out that the capacitor is the one that's actually the one that's causing the issue. So you replace the capacitor and then you go ahead and you charge the customer and you go on your merry way. A few days later, could be a couple days later, could be a couple months later, and the customer goes ahead and calls you back and says, whatever you did not work. My system is still doing the same thing. And there's where the frustration comes, because now you have to go back. So now you're going to lose time and you're going to lose money. All right. And that's the last thing that we want to go ahead and do. We don't want to go ahead and give our customer a free time or free experience or free parts because it was our mistake. We're going to try to avoid that as best as we can. So we always try to do the job as best as we can the first time around. So now, you misdiagnosed the system. Well, maybe you didn't misdiagnose the system. Let's say you did diagnose it correctly. You just didn't diagnose it completely. What do I mean by that? Okay, so why does a capacitor go out? Well, one of the biggest reasons is because my compressor overheats. Why does my compressor overheat? Well, my compressor overheats because either there's a lack of airflow going through my coil or because there's a lack of refrigerant. Which one is it? Well, it's my job to go ahead and find out. As a new technician, it's your job to find out. It's your job to go ahead and see what is actually going on with your air conditioning system. So you find out, in this case, the airflow was the actual problem. That actually is the biggest problem. So you don't tell the customer. And because you didn't tell the customer, then that's why you're there back to try to solve the actual issue. Now, let's say you did tell the customer. Let's say you stated to the customer, look, your capacitor went out. This capacitor does so and so. You go ahead and you inform them. And then you also tell them, well, the reason why your capacitor went out is because your condenser is clogged. There's no adequate airflow going through your condenser. Now, what I'm stating to you is that this may happen again. So I want to go ahead and inform you of this. So as you're giving the invoice, you're going to go ahead and write down, I stated to the customer that they need to go ahead and clean their condenser. The condenser's dirty. There's no adequate airflow. So this is what I'm recommending. And now the customer chooses whether they want to move forward with that job or not, whether they want for you to just replace the capacitor or to replace the capacitor. And then you go ahead and you also provide the service to wash the condenser coil. There is where you now make more money. So you see that? You go ahead and you, let's say you provide a condenser wash, a new filter, and a capacitor change. A new capacitor, all right? So you charge for all that plus your service call. That's a good day's work right there. The customer's satisfied. You're satisfied. It's a win-win for both of you all. You go ahead and you go to the next call. Or maybe it's your last call. And you go home, relax, ease your mind for the next day. As a new technician, remember, always go out there. Always check your airflow. Always make sure that you have adequate airflow going through your air conditioning system. Now, if you want to go ahead and get this, all that I have right here, all that I've written down, I created a flowchart. This flowchart will go ahead and help you understand what you need to check every single time that you go and check an air conditioning system. Every time that you go and service an air conditioning system, this is where you're going to start, and this is where you're going to go ahead and end. So if you want to go ahead and get a copy of the flowchart that I made for you all, the link is down in the description below. You get that copy, you could go ahead and download it, store it in your phone, and you could go ahead and refer to it back later, or you could also print it out. You print it out and you keep it in your work van, you keep it in your work truck, and you could always fall back to it and say, okay, so whenever I'm at a customer's house, this is what I'm going to check, this is what I'm going to go ahead and do, this is where I'm going to start, and this is where I'm going to go ahead and finish. All right, so make sure you check airflow before anything else, even before installing your gauges. Before you install your gauges, make sure you check your airflow first. Then you move on to your pressures, possibly your subcooling, your superheat, to make sure that everything is working the way that it should. All right, so thank you guys for sticking around. Thank you for watching this video. If you did make it all the way to the very end of this video, I want to go ahead and also thank you for the support that you all have been giving me, to myself, to the channel as well. Any questions, any comments that you have had, I've tried to answer them as best as I could, and I continue and will continue to answer them. If you have any comments or any questions, feel free to go ahead and comment in this video with any questions that you all have. If you're new to the field or maybe experienced and you're going through some type of issue, some type of problem that I could help you with, what tools to go ahead and use, what equipment, whatever questions that you all have related to the field, feel free to go ahead and leave a comment down below, and I'll go ahead and get back to you with an answer and answer that question as best as I can. So remember, stay safe, stay positive, continue working out there in the field, continue growing your skill sets, continue getting better as an HVAC technician. All right, so that being said, make sure you leave a like, make sure you subscribe for future videos, and I'll go ahead and I'll see you on the next one.